الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. طيب أوكي. We're talking about, what are we talking about, Akram? Remind us.
We're talking about
Before that, we're talking about the sources of?
Aqeedah.
The sources of Aqeedah. And we said the sources of Aqeedah are?
Quran,
Sunnah, and Ijma'. And we covered talking about the?
Quran.
And we talked about the Sunnah. We mentioned the meaning of the?
Sunnah.
We talked about the importance of the?
Sunnah.
And then we talked about how the Quran tells us to follow. We talked about the companions, right? And how they respected and they follow the Sunnah of the Prophet. We talked about the Imams of the Madhahib and the scholars of the past. What did they do?
They
all emphasized on the importance of the
Sunnah.
And they said, if you find what I say goes against the Sunnah, what should you go with?
Follow
the Sunnah. And then also we said that when it comes to the Sunnah, there are some people that put what?
Conditions
upon the Sunnah. And here we mean they put condition. When we say they put condition on the Sunnah, we mean they put condition on the Hadith. On the what? On the Hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Taib, okay. When we look at a Hadith, we look at it from three ways. What are those three ways?
Oh,
if it's...
Ayub. So you look at the Hadith, if it's authentic or if it's not what?
Authentic.
If it's accepted or if it's what?
Rejected.
Rejected. That's one way, okay? Second, you look at it from what way? Umar?
How many narrators does the Hadith
You look
have?
At how many narrators the Hadith what?
Has.
Comes with. Now you're looking at the chain, okay? You're looking at how many reporters are mentioning this what? This Hadith. And if this Hadith is being mentioned by a large group of people, so much people are mentioning this Hadith that it's impossible for them to what? All like say the same thing like this. What do we call this?
Mutawatir.
What is it called? And what does mutawatir mean linguistically by itself? Something as what? Many. Consecutive. Okay? One after another. One after another. One after another. And then if a Hadith is not mentioned by a lot of people, it doesn't reach the level of the first one. What is that called?
Ahad.
This is called a Hadith what? Ahad. And then we also mention, what is the third thing that you look at when it comes to the Hadith?
Who the Hadith
is attributed what?
To.
Good job, Sharif. So the third thing you look at is the Hadith. Who is it going?
Back
to. So if it goes back to Allah, what is it called?
Qudsi.
If it goes back to the Prophet?
Marfur.
If it goes back to the companions?
Mawquf.
And if it goes to the students of the companions?
Maqtur.
Very good. Now, we mentioned that a hadith ahad also has another name. What is it called? Khabar ahad. What is it called? Or khabar wahid. What is it called? Khabar wahid. Or hadith? Ahad or Khabar Ahad. All of these names are the names for the same for the same thing. So some people they said that when it comes to Aqeedah, when it comes to the belief, they say we will only take the Hadith if it's what? If it's mutawatir. And if the Hadith is if the hadith is ahad and it's about our belief, what do they say?
We won't take
they
it.
Said we will not take it. Why?
Because it's by a symbol.
Because they said that this is the belief, and for us to believe something, we want it to what? It has to be narrated by many, many people, and we don't want to believe something
that was
when it's only
by
mentioned
very
by
few,
by few people. But they said when it comes to the action, when it comes to the fiqh,
then they'll take it.
Then they will what?
Take it.
So they say when it comes to the belief, we don't?
Take it.
But when it comes to the action, we will?
Take it.
We will take it. Tayyib, okay. And what do we say about that?
That's very
And we said that this is a bad what?
Understanding.
This is a wrong understanding as well. And we also mentioned, why is this? What were some of the proof that we mentioned? Taysir? We said the first thing we said, who's the companion? The Prophet sent Mu'adh ibn Jabal to go to where? To Yemen. And to call to the people of Yemen to what?
Islam.
And the first thing the Prophet told Mu'adh to call them to is what? La ilaha illa tawheed. And tawheed is what? It's belief, right? So the Prophet sent Mu'adh to teach them both belief and action. And he was what?
One.
Do we understand this point?
Yeah.
What's another example we gave, Samir?
The alcohol.
When the alcohol became haram, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what did he do?
He sent one of
the companions went and in the street telling the people what? Khamar is now haram. Completely. Did they say, but you're only one person?
No.
Also, what about when the Qibla changed? We didn't mention this yesterday, but also yeah. Another example is when the Qibla what?
Changed.
They were in the Salah, facing where? Al-Aqsa. And the companion came and said that what? Now we have to face the Kaaba. In the middle of the Salah, what did the companions do?
Turn.
They turned. Did they say, but you're only one person?
No.
No. What's another example? Also, we also said that every action that you do, every action comes with a what? Belief, right? For you to do action, before the action, you have to believe that this is something that, okay, you have to pray. This is action, right? But this action, you have to believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made wajib obligation for you to pray. So every action comes with a
belief.
So it's not, so it cannot be correct that they say that we accept this type of hadith for action, but we don't accept it for belief, because every action comes with a belief. Everything is connected together. What's another example that we give?
The quote convey about me.
And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told us, he said what? Balighu anni walaw ayah. The Prophet said, convey about me, spread my message, even if it's one
person,
even if it's one verse. Did the Prophet make a condition that it has to be a lot of people, right? Each one of you convey what you, as long as what you know from the Prophet is what?
Right.
Correct. As long as the information is correct, you should convey. What else did we mention? So what's our principle? So this is their principle. Their principle is that they take hadith mutawatir on for belief. And if it's And for the hadith ahad, they reject it for the belief. But they take a hadith ahad for the action. What's our principle? Akram?
That we take anything that is accepted.
Our principle is that what, as long as the hadith is what?
Accepted
and authentic and sound, we will take it and we'll apply it to both action and
belief.
And belief as well. Very good. And then we gave some examples. We said that there are some ahadith that is about what? Our belief in Aqeedah that came to us in ahad. We mentioned this, right? We mentioned that there are some ahadith that is hadith ahad. Okay? Is it hadith what?
Ahad.
And it talks about our Aqeedah. So do we have to believe in this hadith?
Yeah.
What are some examples? Akram.
There was what's it called? The Hellfire was saying, I want more people. And then Allah put his foot over it.
Very good. The hadith where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تزال جهنم تقول هل من مزيد حتى يضع رب العزة فيها قدمه فتقول قط قط. Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that the hellfire will keep on saying, are there any more people? Because it wants what? More people to burn. Until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to do what?
Destroy the space.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to put his foot over it. Okay? So what do we learn from this? Allah has a what? Do we know how this foot is?
No.
Do we know how many foot? Do we ask this?
No.
Do we believe in it?
Yes.
Yes. Yeah. This hadith, is it mutawatir or ahad? It's ahad. Do we have to believe it? Very good. What's another hadith? Omar. Say that again. Okay.
I forgot what
the legend
said. Someone
between
Allah's fingers.
Adam's son is heart between Allah's fingers.
Very good. The Prophet told us that Inna quluba bani Adam kullaha bayna isbi'aini min asabi'i ar-Rahman. The Prophet said that the heart of the people, the heart of the son of Adam is between the fingers of
Allah.
That's why some people sometimes they are good and all of a sudden they become
bad.
What changed? Their heart, right? Sometimes they're bad and they turn
good.
That's why the most important dua is to make what? Oh Allah, make our heart
pure.
Firm and pure on the what? On the religion. This hadith, what do we learn from this hadith?
That Allah has fingers.
Allah has fingers. Do we know how many fingers?
No.
Do we ask how?
No.
Do we believe in it?
Yeah.
Yes. This hadith, ahad or mutawatir?
Ahad,
do we believe in it? What's another example? Allah is what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is happy when the slave makes tawbah, comes back to him. What do we learn from this?
Allah has feelings.
Allah is happy. He has this attribute of happiness. Do we believe in it?
Yes.
This hadith, ahad or mutawatir? Ahad. Now, as a conclusion, so we end with this, we say that when it comes to Aqeedah, when it comes to our belief, we accept the hadith if it's mutawatir or if it's as long as what? So we don't ask is this hadith ahada? We ask if it's authentic or? And we apply it for both action and for?
Belief.
Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu.